With their league form leaving a lot to be desired as of late, St. Louis FC would look to bounce back as they played host to Loudoun United FC at Worldwide Technology Soccer Park. The team's last league win coming approximately 2 months ago, the fans would hope the post-game fireworks would not be the only cause of oohs and ahs throughout the evening. Could the boys deliver a much-needed home result? Let's go to the highlights and find out.
Tonight, St. Louis FC plays in front of the home folks, hopeful for some fireworks on the pitch as St. Louis FC takes on Loudoun United. Now to Sorto, middle of the pitch, works against the defender. They lay it off to Sinclair, gets behind the defense, sends it into the box, a shot and a goal coming out from the backside is Kyle Murphy. 41st minute, 1-0 Loudoun. So a left corner flag restart for Loudoun. They play a short ball. They leave it there for Bustamante. Oh, there's Nelson. Top of the box. Two shot and a goal. Left wide open. Nelson Martinez in the 51st minute makes it 2-0. Goes to the box. Still with it there. Looks for help. Lays it off for Cicerone. Russell sends it towards goal. A header and a goal. Kyle Gregg at the top of the sixth. 57th minute. 2-1.
What a beautiful ball whistled into the penalty area by Russell Cicerone. And number 22, Kyle Gregg, gets on the end of it. Good work by St. Louis FC.
Ball played forward by St. Louis, goes too far, but saved over there by St. Louis's Dakers. Top of the box there with his Hilton. Drives inside, turns, a shot. There's a loose ball. Cicerone picks it up inside the six-yard box. A goal. We're level at two in the 73rd.
Across the goal mouth, and there's Cicerone for an equalizer in the 73rd minute.
There's the whistle, and we have reached full time here tonight at Worldwide Technology Soccer Park. St. Louis scores two goals late in the second half, and tonight we have a 2-2 draw between St. Louis FC and Loudoun United.
I've said it all along, we have to understand the importance of keeping clean sheets. We keep clean sheets, we'll finish at the upper part of the standings, because we will score enough goals, trust me.
Can never fault this group's work ethic and this group's fight, believing in ourselves, believing in each other, and it's instilled in us every day at practice from Ant and the rest of the coaching staff, and then every guy believes in it.
Big personal accolade tonight, netted your 50th goal in USL competition. What's your takeaway from all 50 of those goals, if you can recount all of them for us one by one right now? It'd be great.
No. I mean, obviously it's a big personal goal of mine. It's exciting for me, but at the same time, like, I'm a team-centered player, and so obviously I wanted a result for the squad, but to be able to net my 50th, especially for this club, was really special for me.
And the boys will be on short rest with arguably the biggest match in franchise history on deck. Wednesday, July 10th, a 6:30 p.m. showdown at Atlanta United. This is the quarterfinals of the U.S. Open Cup, where St. Louis FC will play the reigning MLS League champ. Watch it on ESPN+. On behalf of all of us here at St. Louis FC and the rest of the Fleur-de-Lis faithful, thanks for watching.